Good job.
I have mitts on. I'm safe. Let's see.
Someone should sit here. There you go.
Come on in.
So this is the Brad and others will know this one from other times. So this is the most original room in the building. It hasn't been changed. You'll notice in the rest of the building, the oak's been changed to the lighter oak. They've restained it. That happened in, I think, the 60s. This is how the oak was originally. This is dark oak. So this room's never been touched, and neither, I hope it never will be. Although we've got to find a way to repair the carpet, because it's kind of getting a little nasty. And remember that cabinet table I showed you in my office? That used to sit in the middle. So this is how much government's gotten bigger. So you have ministers that ran the whole province that could fit around that table in there. And now we fit comfortably around here, but we're actually a smaller cabinet than the one before that was even bigger than that yet. So there's a lot of, these are all the ministers' names, and they know who they are, but we kind of have the name tags for events like this when people come in. For example, there's Don McMorris. His kids go to Lavoldis, right? He's the health minister. And Bill Hutchinson's from Regina South. He's the minister of First Nations and Métis Relations. He's over in, what school would be over in Regina South then?
Campbell. Well, depends.
Campbell would be right
there. Campbell, Lavoldis.
But Lavoldis, I think, is in, yeah, I think it's in Wascana. Yeah. Anyway, so this is the cabinet room, and this is where I made my first mistake. It was 2 days after we won the election. Well, not 2 days, it was a bit longer than that. Mr. Calvert, who was the premier before, was very helpful when we were trying to make the transition. The government has to change, and hopefully it goes smoothly, and so he was very good about it. He got us into these offices quickly, and when the day we got into the office, we got a gift from the Riders. In 2007, the Riders were on a tear towards the Grey Cup, you remember that? So they had sent a flag, signed by the whole team, to congratulate our new government. So I asked the people in the building, you know, we got this flag, we should probably hang it somewhere. Where can we hang it? And one of the people that runs the building says, you have a flag pole outside your office, right on the balcony. So we called all the media down here on a Saturday, before they went to play BC Lions in the Western Final. And we hung it for good luck. And I got a call from people who knew the protocol. You guys know what protocol is. Those are all the rules in place. Got a call from the people who know protocol, and they said, you know, actually, Brad, they didn't call me Brad. They said, you know what, that flagpole is for Her Majesty the Queen or Her Majesty the Queen's representative when they're in the building. But who would be the representative of Her Majesty the Queen?
In Saskatchewan?
Yeah.
Gordon Barnhart.
Right, Gordon Barnhart, the lieutenant governor, right? Each province has a representative of the Queen, the head of Canada. And that's for when he's in the building for Throne Speech Day or something, his flag flies or her flag flies out there. So they asked me, well, are you ever going to do that again? And you kind of messed that up. And I said, no. If you look out there just now, the flag is fine. Because if the Riders are going to the Western Final, that's like royalty, right? We're hosting. Sometimes it's better to ask for forgiveness than permission. So yesterday we had Gene Mikowski and Wes Cates and Jim Hobson out in the balcony. And we hung the flag, the Rider flag. They've signed it again. And I said, Jim, I hope this is okay. And he said, yeah, I'm superstitious. I'm going to do everything we did in 2007 to see if it was really great. Anyway, that's the place I made my first mistake. And now I've repeated the mistake. And I hope I have to repeat it every single year. So here's where we hopefully try to make the best decisions for the province, best as we can. And they actually get approved by the legislature, by the MLAs here. But they really start in this room. And, you know, again, it's a pretty inspiring place to try to do work. And we just hope that you're doing the, you know, making the right decisions for it. For you guys and for your parents and for the city.
What's up?
What's what? Any questions?
Yeah. How long would it have been?
Yes, we met last Wednesday. It was about 3 hours. No, about 2 hours. We meet every Wednesday in this room, and when it's ahead of budget time. When it's ahead of budget time, it's a little longer than that, but it's like when we're trying to do the budgets, probably, you know, a number of meetings at 4 hours or something. But this one was not. Mercifully, it was short. Some of the stuff's exciting, like we were trying to, you know, sometimes you're deciding stuff about parks, you know, or tours, and it's kind of interesting stuff. And sometimes it's a little bit more mundane. It's about little tiny statutes, miscellaneous legislation you got to pass that you don't think would change much of the world if it passes or doesn't, but you do, you got to do those things too. There you have it. That's the 5 cent tour. I hope it was worth every penny. Thanks again for the torch front, you guys. And George, thank you for what you're doing.
You're welcome. Let's get the premier round of applause.
You didn't get that, did you?
Oh, yeah. Feel kind of dope.
I am.
I cleaned that painting yesterday.
Is it?
Oh yeah, I remember that I went to a tour here in grade 8, and it was clean for spring.
Yeah.
Hopefully they didn't get my mask. They cut that out because
I seriously can't even watch you fall.
Hey.
With the camera.
No, because that would be bad.
What's this camera?
Videoing for?
You can get like health benefits because you.
What's this videoing for?
There's a kitty corner.
Oh. I need a picture of her. Oh, I want a picture too.
You guys are silly.
I was here on Canada Day. I felt awesome.
Hey. Thank you. You did a great job. Thank you. Okay. Okay, you guys were great. Thank you. Remember to watch the news tonight and the papers. Great job again, Joe.
Thank you again.
Okay.
Are you going to come back?
No, I have to get going, but I'm going to stay in touch with your school and everybody else to follow up after this.
Thank you again.
Yeah, there's probably honor. A fundraiser that's going to be coming up, and you know, you guys will get another chance to do another awareness thing.
Have a good evening.
Thanks, bro.
Yeah, I guess.
Yep. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, thanks, guys. Don't miss the bus.